Turn any day into a party with amazing cocktails made with Stella Rosa wines, like the tropical Stella Rosa Rita. Mix Stella Rosa pineapple with orange liqueur, tequila, guava juice, and lime juice. Shake what your mama gave you, then pour over ice and enjoy. Mmm. Find more delicious drink recipes at StellaRosaWines.com/cocktails.
Celebrate! Stella Rosa!
Celebrate responsibly.
Think you're driving somewhere close? And you don't need a seatbelt? Think it's only for the people in the front? Think it takes too much to buckle up? Think again. 2 seconds and a won't cost you a dime, but they can save your life. Do it for your family. Buckle up.
Brought to you by the Virginia Department of Motor Vehicles.
Ready to become a master of the minutiae surrounding Cougar athletics? Well, you've come to the right place. This is Cougar Sports with Ben Crittle on ESPN 960 and 94.5 FM.
Yeah, a little funky Friday today. This is Cougar Sports, ESPN 960. Wild Cherry bringing us back from the break. Play that funky music. That's the band of the day, the artist of the day, always brought to you by RoyalArmyBrand.com. BYU swag crew to buy fans for fans. Stay loyal to that Royal. Rep the Y the right way. Purchase all your BYU licensed apparel at RoyalArmyBrand.com. You'll love it. Conversational pieces. The best licensed apparel in the business. Friends or family members will love it. Check out the clearance aisle right now, too. I know you love the deals. Get the discount. Get discounts today at RoyalArmyBrand.com. We've had a great show thus far. Just talked some Big 12 football. Barry Trammell says a good 13th team for the Big 12 would be Boise State, but he can't think of a good 14th team if the Big 12 decided to expand beyond the current teams. Is there a 14th team out there that could join the Big 12? And if so, Fox on the Box says the conference footprint is already massive. May as well go coast-to-coast and add San Diego State. Greg Welch says Arizona State. Alec Watson says maybe Colorado State. Utah man BQ says possibly San Diego State. Good football, good basketball, plus would bring in the Cali market. See, I love hopping on to BYU Sports Nation. Yeah, we got you. BYU Sports Nation. Let's get into some basketball talk in this set. I want to talk Colin Chandler. What a big get it was to get Colin Chandler. Colin Chandler had his pick of the litter, if you will, in the recruiting world. And somehow, some way, Mark Pope pulled it off, got Colin Chandler to commit. And he had offers from Arizona, Oregon, Stanford, Utah. He's a four-star at Farmington, Utah in the class of 2022. And most recently, he had Creighton, Utah State, Gonzaga was hot on his list, and USC as well. Utah Tech was his first offer, by the way. But recently, he was arguably snubbed. Like, he did not receive the McDonald's All-American title, and I was a little bit saddened by it. And recently, he went out to New Orleans to, I believe, compete in a tournament and a camp. And I want to talk about with a guy that was in attendance. He's the owner of Relentless Hoops, and it's an accredited scouting service. And we want to welcome in Trent Markwit to join the show. Trent, how you living, man?
Doing well. How about you? Thanks for having me.
Hey, thanks for hopping on to give us some insight. So, Trent, tell us a little bit about what you do on the daily for Relentless Hoops.
Yeah, so I live in Atlanta, based out of the southeast. I run a NCAA-approved scouting service that a variety of different college programs subscribe to. So I help them identify prospects throughout the southeast and other regions, as we're about to talk about with Colin. But I just watch a bunch of high school and travel basketball throughout the year, and it's a lot of fun. Things are starting to ramp up with the travel circuit now, so about to get going and see a lot of different players.
So what's going on out there in New Orleans right now? You mentioned earlier today BYU signee Colin Chandler looked like he might have been a McDonald's snub last week in New Orleans. Smooth, balanced offensive game with explosiveness, also takes what the defense gives him and knows when to use each of his skills. You saw him last week. Where were you and why?
Yeah, so the Final Four was held in New Orleans, as most people know, but Ryan Silver of West Coast Elite and All-Academic Basketball teamed up to do what they call now as the All-Academic All-American game. So they brought in a lot of high academic kids from around the country that are also really good players. You know, Colin was out there. It could go into Texas, Notre Dame, St. Mary's, a bunch of different guys. So they kind of, you know, mixed that in with the Final Four and everything going on. So they had a an underclassmen game with some rising seniors who are juniors now. And then they had the senior game, which Colin was in. So I was able to see the practices first on Thursday night and then the actual game that they did Friday. And I had seen Colin, you know, a good bit on the travel circuit when his Utah prospects team was able to come to the south southeast region. But, you know, I thought he looked even better in this setting, which, you know, makes sense with an all-star game. But with the practices, they were, you know, competitive, and he really stood out.
So let's get into it. Why, in your opinion, or yeah, I don't know, why not, you know, in this debate, was BYU signee Colin Chandler snubbed from that McDonald's All-America status?
Possibly. Like, there had been a lot of discussion about that when the selections were first made back earlier in the winter. You know, there are guys who, you know, have bigger names, have been, you know, known longer, more, or ranked higher for a longer time. But I felt like throughout the spring and summer, he was playing, you know, every weekend in top events, producing at a consistent rate. It wasn't like he just, you know, played one weekend and took a month or two off. He was there, you know, every event for the Utah prospects and got it done every time. And I think what really, you know, stamped it for me is when I saw him at the end of July at the MBPA Top 100 camp. He really held his own and played well there, did so efficiently. And, you know, I'm glad I was able to get another chance at seeing him last week as well. And that just kind of further solidified, you know, the fact that he, you know, should have had a real shot at getting it. I don't know who you could say to take out. There are a lot of good wing shooting guards that made the game, but I think, you know, he proved that he was definitely deserving.
What type of impact do you think he can make for this BYU Cougar basketball team? What skill sets does he bring to the roster?
Well, he's, like I said on Twitter, he has a really balanced, well-rounded game. He's, you know, he has a good size at, you know, 6'4", 6'5". He's primarily a shooting guard right now, but I think he is going to have the ability to play both guard spots in times. He has a really good feel for the game. He has an effortless shot that has, you know, range that extends to the, you know, well beyond the new college three-point line. He doesn't have wasted movements. He's efficient. And he has, you know, he has good vision too. That's why I think he could, you know, maybe play on the ball some and play some point guard in time. And he can sneak up on you with his athleticism. He always seems to be calm and poised, which I think will really help him at the college level. You know, things aren't too fast for him. He's not going to panic. And I think, as you know, he adds strength, he's going to be, you know, really a dynamic scorer.
What do you think? I mean, obviously he was recruited highly recruited around the country. What are the blue blood programs? How do they view LDS recruits that are going to be going on missions for 2 years? Have you gotten any insight, any knowledge, any commentary from coaches around the country how they view the Latter-day Saint recruit that's going to be serving a 2-year mission?
That's a good question. I mean, you know, it's something that isn't very common at that level to have a kid that's that good that is going to be taking that mission. You know, I think college coaches would be, you know, maybe attracted to the fact that he's going to be older, but they also are going to be wondering, all right, you know, he's going to be away from the country or whatever, from basketball and college for, you know, 2 years. What's he going to look like coming back? There's some uncertainty with that, but I think as BYU has shown with some of their other guys, it's worked out. So I think maybe with, you know, continued record of that, you know, it might influence some even bigger programs to take that on and be willing to accept, you know, that type of player.
Yeah, it's interesting debate, and I wondered if you had any knowledge on the situation. So we're talking some Colin Chandler here with Trent Markwith, owner of Relentless Hoops here on Cougar Sports ESPN 960. Out of all the players that were in attendance, where would you say that Colin Chandler ranked at the camp that you were at?
I think he was right up there, either maybe the best, maybe second best. I think him and Rowan Brumbaugh, who's going to Texas, were, you know, probably the two top guys that really stood out. I think those two, and then Dom Campbell that's going to Notre Dame, Aiden Mahaney that's going to St. Mary's, and then Damarian Watson. Those five I thought were the best, but I think Colin and Brumbaugh were, you know, really at the top.
What does it say? I mean, these kids are also high academic young men, and that's not always, you know, the emphasis, the focus, especially now with NIL. It's even more at the forefront. It's about the athlete-student rather than the student-athlete. I feel like even the NCAA is caving, and they have to cave, you know, to the greater population and what our capitalistic, sports-minded society is looking for. But these guys are still student-athletes, it seems.
Yes, definitely. And I honestly, you know, the NCAA is clearly feeling the heat about, you know, having to mix in, you know, ways for guys to make money. But I think that, you know, speaks loudly that these guys are at a high level, both academically and athletically, because that's going to help them once they are in college. That shows that they can already, you know, handle, you know, the academic side of things. They're going to be able to manage their time. And I think it, you know, shows a maturity to have that academic track record throughout your entire high school career and, you know, continue it while balancing being, you know, a really high-level basketball player.
Trent, great getting to know you, man. How is it that we can support you and what you do, brother?
What'd you say?
Yeah, what is it that we can do to support you? I appreciate you hopping on. You're the owner of Relentless Hoops. How can we support what you do?
Anything. If you, you know, just put out that I was on the show, I'd love for, you know, people to hear it. You know, this isn't something that I do that often, but I enjoy getting to, you know, talk about new players and reach out to new fan bases, stuff like that. So and anything like that, I'd really appreciate it.
Final question for you. Do you know of any other prospects that BYU's taking a look at right now in the transfer portal or in the high school ranks? I know you're in a geographic region where BYU does not typically recruit. But, you know, you see who BYU did recruit this go-around with Colin Chandler. Do you know of any other guys that BYU is targeting?
I haven't seen a ton. I've seen BYU pop up with a few different transfers, but there are so many kids in the portal right now and so many schools going after, you know, all these different guys. So I wouldn't really be able to pinpoint too many right now. This weekend is actually the first weekend that coaches can be out to see high school prospects, so they're probably going to be able to identify some of their, you know, more serious guys that they want to, you know, recruit into the summer. You know, the Nike circuit's in Orlando right now. Under Armour's and Adidas are both in Indianapolis, so I'm sure the BYU coaches will be out at that and trying to find the next Cougar.
Indeed they will be. Trent Markwith, follow him on Twitter, TMarkwith14, the owner of Relentless Hoops. Thanks so much, Trent.
Thank you.
It's clear to you that de-icing the wings will not be done in a jiffy. You look for phone outlets but see none, only photos of phone outlets. A voice announces your gate is now 39C, 12B, 9A. It's like musical chairs if musical chairs made you sob in the pet relief area. A child picking his nose stares. His parents have abandoned him. The airport will raise him now.
Don't let flight delays ruin your vacation. Go on a real vacation. GoRVing.com.
Help Jews in poverty at helpjewsnow.org. Your $25 gift today will help provide a life-saving food box to Jews in need. Be a blessing right now. Visit helpjewsnow.org. That's helpjewsnow.org.